The Middle East region is known for many things, including conflicts. But what it's probably less known about is its very, very young demographic. 65% below the age of 30. That's 200 million Arab youth. And if you really need to understand this region, you really need to understand the hearts and minds of these people. What do they think of their present and their future? And one of the most stunning findings we've seen this year is about how they see the role of religion in society, and they want religion to play less and less of a role, and in some ways a voice that is talking about bringing about a difference between state and religion. And that's a very, very interesting finding. But more importantly is how young people are seeing the pressures that are coming from what we call kitchen table issues. The two top concerns that young people have is the rising cost of living and unemployment. And as you know, Dan, unemployment is at a record level in the Middle East. In fact, the highest in the world. Around 30% of the 15 to 24-year-olds are out of work. And that is a pressing problem for the governments in the Middle East to resolve.
So this is very significant for policymakers when they look over the results of this latest survey. Are they listening? Do they have the ear and the minds of young people in the region?
I think more and more, especially during the recent past, especially after the Arab Spring, I think governments have to listen to their citizenry. And in many ways, our poll, which is the largest of its kind, of the region's largest demographic, has received a very, very good response from the government. A lot of governments are keen to know how the concerns, how their hopes are tracking over the last 10 years. And that's the big value of the Arab Youth Survey that we bring out every year.
I wanted to ask you about another aspect of the report, and I mentioned this just before as well. It also points out that the majority of young people in the region now see the United States as an enemy of sorts, which I think is quite interesting, over an ally. And also the role and the influence of Russia also appears to be rising in the minds of these young people as well. So how do we explain that trend, and what does it tell us?
It is actually not a new trend, especially during the last few years, especially after the Syrian conflict rose its head, and Russia played a very, very significant role in Syrian conflict. I think the kind of image of Russia as an ally started increasing, especially in the Levantine region. The United States is understandably less seen as an ally, since they have retreated from the region in many ways. After the Obama presidency, the Trump presidency has taken a number of steps that have kind of created some kind of turmoil in the minds of young people, especially the ban on Muslims entering the United States, the move to take the United States Embassy into Jerusalem, and the recent decision on Golan Heights has changed how people see the United States as an enemy. But more importantly, when we ask them, who are your biggest allies, they have chosen the United Arab Emirates and Saudi Arabia as their allies. So when you see the whole foreign relations aspect, the diplomacy aspect is changing, with young Arabs looking at their own leaders, and the mantle of leadership has now fallen on to Abu Dhabi and Riyadh.
Hi, I'm Emily Tan, and thanks for watching CNBC. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more. Thanks for watching.